Okay, so part two of this, we're going to solve this problem right here. And the way you solve this is always draw a picture. Now you just have to have those diagrams memorized, know what's where, right? And we got to, when we read a problem like this, we say, where do we start? Let's get my pens here. We start with, well, Mars is at opposition and is setting. That tells us a whole bunch right there. So, we always start, we put the sun here, we put the earth here. And then, excuse me, allergies are getting me. And then we say Mars is at opposition. Well, I know what opposition means. It means that the sun is on one side of the earth and Mars is on the opposite. So Mars has to be over here. So here's Mars at opposition. So I already know where Mars is. So that makes a straight line. But it also says Mars is setting. All right, setting, remember, is time of day. And time of day is where Herb is around the earth. And if I put Herb up here, remember we did this before, we know that the earth spins counterclockwise to the east, and this is west. If I put Herb up here, east is pointing towards Mars. Well, that can't be right because Mars should be setting, so Mars has to be in the west. So that's not the right Herb. So it's not at that time, so let's try another one. So I'm not going to put it here because then Mars would be overhead, but I'm going to put Herb down here and see if this one works. So I put Herb down here. Remember the Earth spins counterclockwise, so it's spinning this way. So this way is east, this way is west. The sun is rising because you're at 6 a.m. And the moon, Mars is setting. So we have now Mars at opposition and setting. Here is Herb, right here. I already figured out what time it is. It is 6 a.m. So I got part of the answer. Now I just got to figure out where to put Jupiter and Saturn. Well, the meridian, remember, is that imaginary line that goes from north to south straight over your head. So that's got to be straight over Herb's head. So down here is going to be Jupiter. Remember, that makes a 90 degree angle. So Jupiter is in western quadrature. Remember, I just go back to that chart that we just had, and we say, oh, Jupiter down here, so that's a 90 degree angle, is in western quadrature. And then it says Saturn is rising, so Saturn has to be in the east. East points this way. So Saturn's got to be over here. Remember, it's way further out here. Am I off? I'm probably off the thing. But Saturn's way over here in the direction towards the sun, which means Saturn is in conjunction because it's in the same exact direction as the sun is. There we go. That would be the answer to that problem. It's 6 a.m. Jupiter is in western quadrature and Saturn is in conjunction. I'm going to do one more as an example. Okay? So let's do another. Alright. The first quarter moon is setting and occulting Mars. Jupiter is on the meridian. Saturn is rising. What time is it? And what planetary configurations are Mars, Jupiter,
and Saturn in.
All right. How do we do this? We do this exact same way. We start with a picture. So here's the sun. Here's the earth. Right here, okay? Now, we got a lot to put on this picture. First of all, we got the moon again. So we have to remember what the moon is. First quarter moon, that tells us where the moon has to be. So the moon is going to be right here. Well, so I drew it kind of small because we got to put the planets on there too. So there's the moon, and it's and the first quarter moon is setting. So setting means it has to be to the west. So I have to figure out where Herb is. So the moon is setting. And I'm going to put Herb over here. And if I draw his horizon, remember, east is this way because the Earth spins this way, and west is this way. West is pointing up to the moon. So there's where Herb has to be. So I figured out the time. The time is midnight. Okay? Now, I haven't used the word occulting before. Occulting means it's passing in front of or blocking the back, what's behind it. So what happens is since moon is closer to us than planets, the moon will go and pass in front of the planets and block them out for a while. That's called an occultation. So occulting means it's blocking it, which means Mars has to be right behind it. So up here would be Mars. It's in the exact same direction as the moon. But we know from our diagram, if Mars is up there, it's got to be an eastern quadrature. And then we have Jupiter on the meridian. Remember, the meridian's overhead. So here's Herb. So Jupiter overhead, we'll put Jupiter out here. Jupiter out here, remember, it goes Jupiter, Earth, Sun. It's opposite, so Jupiter is in opposition. And then Saturn is rising, so it has to be in the east. So Saturn is down here. If Saturn is down there, then remember this makes a 90-degree angle. It would be in eastern, a western quadrature. There you go. There are all your answers. So when you read the question, you say, oh man, how am I ever going to figure this out? But it's not that bad. Once you draw the picture, it all kind of makes sense. And that is planetary configurations. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to start talking about how modern astronomers use these things to figure out things about the solar system.